Okay, welcome to my first review of the authentic Gawharet Elfan Egyptian Rabab. Now, I'm sure I mispronounced that because I don't speak Arabic or any kind of Arabic at all. This is the instrument. It really looks a great deal like the picture that you see on Amazon.com or on eBay. Depending on where you're getting it from. Right out of the box, it's, you know, I mean, it is totally assembled. Not that there's really any assembly necessary for the thing. I wanted to make note of just one or two things. Now, the first thing is that if you're interested in like Iranian Comanche, or you know, like the Turkish spike fiddle, which look, both of them look a lot like the Egyptian rabab here, it's not that. It doesn't sound like that. It doesn't play like that. And I'll show you just one or two things. The first thing, and I think you can see this. It's hard to see in like the eBay photos or the Amazon.com photos, but you'll see there's no nut, right? So if you pluck it, right, it almost has like a javadi effect, you know, with without there being a nut there. It kind of just like resonates against where the string comes over here. Okay, the second thing that I want to make you aware of is the bridge. Now, if you see, the bridge is just a curved piece of wood that they've cut two notches in. Again, it's fine for the instrument, but you know, a Comanche bridge or a Turkish spike fiddle bridge is different than this, and that changes the sound. Now, you could probably make some alterations to it, but I think that that's really more work than you probably want to do. If you're really into either of those two instruments, it's better to just get those instruments, right? Now, one alteration that I did make to it, and I hope you can see, I put a piece of leather in between the actual spike part and the sound box. And the reason is because the strings were cutting in a little bit to the skin here, and I think this is fish skin, so, and fish skin has kind of a very, like, nasal resonant quality. Now, before I actually play it for you, I have to preface by saying I've only had this thing for a few days, you know, and I played on it not very much. I am a pianist by trade, so the sound that you're going to hear come out of this is not going to be the greatest sound ever, but this might give you an idea of where you're going to be when you start working with this. If you're a violinist, you know, or a cellist, or if you've worked with bowed lutes before of any kind, you'll probably have a much easier time than me. Also, there's no rabab teachers in Arizona where I live. And so, you know, I have no idea as to the actual technique for this, but you probably don't either. You know, I've watched a few YouTube videos of other people playing, really good musicians, and I'm sorry my camera isn't, it doesn't appear to be wide enough to actually show you all of this, but the bow that you would receive is this. It's basically just a bent piece of bamboo with some horsehair tied to it. You have to rosin the heck out of it, and I have. I'll go ahead and play. I'll start with this bow, and I'm sorry you can't see where I'm actually bowing on this, but the sound, when you get started, like I am, is pretty much... And again, bear in mind that I'm not a rabab player. In my experimenting, I've actually found it a little bit easier to use a violin bow. And I grip it in the old underhand way, right, for playing. And the reason why is that the grip for this, it feels a little off. So if there are any expert rabab players out there, feel free to post a video response correcting me. But I'm going to go ahead and try it with the violin bow now, and you guys can kind of tell me what you think. So that just gives you kind of an idea, you know, of what it sounds like when you get started. Maybe I'll do a video in the future, you know, after I get to work on it a little bit more, and you'll see if there is any actual improvement. But this is the Gawharet Elfan Rabab. It's available on Amazon.com. It's also available on eBay, and there's a few other smaller internet sites, you know, that have this instrument. It retails, I think, for about $90. That's what I paid for it. And then shipping is like $8 in there. So thank you very much. Have a wonderful day.